Okay, so today we are talking about calculating the slope of a line. Well, you have been told that slope of a line is a ratio. That means a comparison of two things. But what am I comparing? I'm comparing the vertical rise to its horizontal rise. So what I am really finding is the rate of change. What is the rate of change of this linear function? Sometimes we'll refer to it as the steepness of a line. Now, slope, we are given a formula for slope because we're wanting to find the change of the vertical rise as compared to the horizontal run. So we will subtract the y values of the ordered pairs and compare that to the difference of the x values of the ordered pairs. Now, another way of representing it is to say it's the change in y. Now, that triangle actually is representing a Greek letter in the alphabet called delta, and delta is change in. So we have the change in y over the change in x. So you should be familiar with all three ways of representing slope. So for this problem, we're given two values, 1, 4, so let's call that my first ordered pair, and 3, 0, that's my second ordered pair. So according to my formula for slope, I'm going to subtract the y values, so 0 minus 4, and compare that to the difference of the x values, 3 minus 1. So I end up with negative 4 over 2. And then if I simplify that, I have negative 2 over 1. You know, you could also just write that negative 2, but I like putting it over 1 because then it clearly shows how I'm going to have a vertical movement of negative 2 and then a horizontal movement of positive 1. And then I'm going to repeat that. Vertical movement of negative 2, horizontal of positive 1. And by using the slope, I can find infinite number of points on my line. Well, let's do one more example without the graph. So let's given you're given two points and you need to calculate the slope. So according to the formula for slope, we're going to find the change in y, so 5 minus 2, compared to the change in x. Negative 6, take away a negative 4. Now just be careful with your integers. 5 minus 2 is 3. We're going to add the opposite, so it'll be over negative 2. Now, is 3 over negative 2, I have a thinking question. Would that be the same as negative 3 over a positive 2? Or the same as the negative 3 halves? So do those imply the same type of comparison? So in this example, if I start off with a point here and I go up 3, left 2, okay, there's my line. Now, would down 3 over 2 work also? Yes, it does. Okay. Good. Wow. Neat. Fabulous. Moving along. Okay. Now let's compare this to what we have learned already. We have been talking about when an equation is written in standard form. And if you remember, the benefits of standard form is that you can easily calculate the x-intercept and the y-intercept. So let's say, for example, we have 7x minus 2y equals 14. If you remember, we can find the x-intercept and the y-intercept. So let's say we let x be 0, and if x is 0, then we know negative 7 times negative 2 is 14. So this would give us the y-intercept. And to find the x-intercept, we want to find the x value when y is 0. So if y is 0, 7 times 2 is 14. That's the benefit. But notice the benefit of standard form is not calculating the slope quickly. In order to calculate the slope quickly, I would need to put my function in slope-intercept form. Okay? Doesn't that make sense? Slope-intercept form? So for slope-intercept form, let's say I have a function y equals 5x plus 2. So we know that slope-intercept form is mx plus b, where m represents the slope and b represents the value of the y-coordinate of the y-intercept. So according to this example here, the slope would be 5, and the y-intercept is 0, 2. Make sure you write the y-intercept as an ordered pair. So going back now to standard form, if I were to rewrite this equation so that it's y equals, so in other words, I have to solve for y. So if I subtract 7x from both sides, so now I have negative 2y equals negative 7x plus 14. And then I divide everything by negative 2. I would now be able to easily identify the slope and y-intercept. Negative over negative is a positive 7/2 x, and then minus 7. So for this example, I could say the slope is 7/2 and the y-intercept is 0, negative 7. Okay, that concludes today's example. Now practice the problems you've been assigned.